So guys, in my hand there's a Samsung Galaxy J7 Prime 32GB version. So first of all, I will give you the overview of the Samsung Galaxy J7 Prime. So on the top you have the nothing, on the right side there's a speaker position and there's the lock key, and on the bottom you have the some mic over here, data syncing and data charging port, the 3.5mm headphone jack, and the left side you have the volume up and down key, and the rear side you have the 13MP f1.9 aperture camera with LED flash, Samsung branded. And on the front side you have the 8 megapixel f2.0 aperture lens, and some mic, the some sensors and LED flash, and the Samsung logo here. And this is the home key, and always it's used also for fingerprint scanner, and this is some of the back key and the recent key. So guys, firstly, what am I don't like or like about this phone? So first of all, what am I like about this phone? So in the first, there's the 5.5 inches HD screen with 386 ppi density, and I like about this display because the display is quite good in this price segment. And the second point, in my opinion, the camera is pretty good in my opinion, but yes, the video quality, video capability is pretty good in this mobile, and the front front camera is also very good, and this can take a pretty good low light camera pics, and also in the daylight camera pics in average. Okay, so and the third pros in my opinion, there's the sound quality in this mobile. Okay, so there's a pretty good sound quality in my opinion, because the speaker position in the right side in here, and that's why the while you put down your devices, there's the speaker is in here, and that's why the speaker gives you a very good sound quality. And in the fourth pros in my opinion, the fingerprint scanner. The fingerprint scanner in this price segment is pretty good. The Samsung tells that the fingerprint is works 0.02 second time. Okay, so I hope this is pretty good and the true opinion, because it's pretty fast from my opinion. And the fifth pros in my opinion, there's the 3GB RAM and 32GB inbuilt storage, and that's mean you can take so much apps, so much games in this phone, and there's the MediaTek chipset, and that's why the games, the heavy loaded games is all pretty smooth in these devices. So guys, let's get straight into the cons. What am I don't like about these devices? So guys, in my opinion, the 5.5 inches HD display is quite a low in today's generation, because all the people looks for a super AMOLED screen, and that's why it doesn't have it, and that's why I hope this is a fast con about these devices. And the second cons in my opinion, because of the there's no backlight keys, because that not backlight, and that's why if you when you are dark in the dark outside and there's no backlight here, you have to search the where is the key. And the third cons in my opinion, there's no NFC, and is also have the Samsung Pay Mini. While in the 15,000 budget oriented devices, Samsung gives this, because Samsung need to gives the NFC, because in this price segment there's any other smartphones have the NFC, and there's the pretty cool features in my opinion. Okay, so that's the pretty cool devices, and in my opinion, if you want to buy a budget oriented branded smartphone, and if you don't heavy user or anything like that, then you straight go for the Samsung Galaxy J7 Prime. So guys, if you like my video, please like, share, comment, and watch the previous videos, and please don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. Bye.